ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। मूकं कृति वाचालं पङ्गुलङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारणं श्रीपरमानन्दमाधवम्। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम सेवेंथ कैंटो चैप्टर 5 टेक्स्ट 5। श्री प्रहलाद उवाच तत्साधु मन्ने असुरवर्य देहिनम् सदा समुद्विग्न धियं हितात्म पापं गृहं अंधकूपं वनं गतो यद् हरिं आश्रयेत। श्रीप्रह्लाद उवाच तत्साधु मन्ने असुरवर्य देहिनम् सदा समुद्विग्न धियं असद्ग्रहा हितात्म पातं गृहं अंधकूपं वनं गतो यद् हरिं आश्रयेत। श्रीप्रह्लाद उवाच तत्साधु मन्ने असुरवर्य देहिनं सदा समुद्विग्न धियं असद्ग्रहा हितात्म पापं गृहं अंधकूपं वनं गतो यद् हरि आश्रयेत। श्री प्रह्लाद उवाच। प्रह्लाद महाराज रिप्लाइड तत् दैट साधु वेरी गुड आर बेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ मन्ने आई थिंक असुरवर्य ओ किंग ऑफ द असुरस देहिनम अ पर्सन्स हु हैव एक्सेप्टेड द मेटेरियल बॉडी सदा ऑलवेज समुद्विग्न फुल ऑफ एंग्जाइटीज धियम हुज इंटेलिजेंस असत ग्रहात because of accepting the temporary body or bodily relations as real. Hitva, giving up, Atmapatam, the place where spiritual culture or self-realization is stopped. Griham, the bodily concept of life or household life. Andhakupam, which is nothing but a blind well. Where there is no water, but no, nonetheless searches for water. Banam, to the forest. Gatah, going. Yat, which. Harim, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Asrayata, may take shelter of. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Prahlad Maharaj replied, O best of the Asuras, King of the Demons, as far as I have learned from my spiritual master, any person who has accepted a temporary body and temporary household life is certainly embarrassed by anxiety because of having fallen in a dark well where there is no water but only suffering. One should give up this position and go to the forest. More clearly, one should go to Vrindavan, where only Krishna consciousness is prevalent, and should thus take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Purport. Hiranyakasipu thought that Prahlad, being nothing but a small boy with no actual experience, might reply with something pleasing, but nothing practical. Prahlad Maharaj, however, being an exalted devotee, had acquired all the qualities of education. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunesh tatra samasate sura harava bhaktasya kuto mahat guna manorathena sati dhavato vahi. One who has unflinching devotional faith in Krishna, consistently manifest all the good qualities of Krishna and the demigods. However, he who has no devotion to the Supreme Personality of Godhead has no good qualification because he is engaged by mental concoction in material existence, which is the external feature of the Lord. So-called educated philosophers and scientists who are simply on the mental platform cannot distinguish between what is actually sat, eternal, and what is asat, temporary. The Vedic injunction is also asotama jyotirgama. Everyone should give up the platform of temporary existence and approach the eternal platform. The soul is eternal, and topics concerning the eternal soul are actually knowledge. Elsewhere it is said, apasyatam atmatattvam gruhesu gruhamedhinam. Those who are attached to the bodily conception of life and who thus stick to life as a grihastha or householder on the platform of material sense enjoyment cannot see the welfare of the eternal soul. Prahlad Maharaj confirmed this by saying that if one wants success in life, he should immediately understand from the right sources what is his self-interest is and how he should mold his life in spiritual consciousness. One should understand himself to be part and parcel of Krishna and thus completely take shelter of his lotus feet for guaranteed spiritual success. Everyone in the material world is in the bodily conception, struggling hard for existence, life after life. Prahlad Maharaj therefore recommended that to stop this material condition of repeated birth and death, one should go to the forest or vana. In the varnashram system, one first becomes a brahmachari, then a grihastha, a vanaprastha, and finally a sannyasi. Going to the forest means accepting vanaprastha life, which is between grihastha life and sannyas. As confirmed in the Vishnu Purana, varnashrama charavata purusena parapuman Vishwar Aradhyate. By accepting this institution of varna and ashram, one can very easily elevate himself to the platform of worshipping Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Otherwise, if one remains in the bodily conception, one must rot within this material world, and his life will be a failure. Society must have divisions of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaisya, and Shudra. And for spiritual advancement, one must gradually develop as a brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyasi. Prahlad Maharaj recommended that his father accept vanaprastha life because as a grihastha, he was becoming increasingly demoniac. Jai Sri Gauranitai Krishna Vallam Sri Radha Sam Sundara Trisakdevi Ki Jai. So Prahlad Maharaj recommended that his father accept vanaprastha life because as a grihastha, he was becoming increasingly demoniac due to bodily attachments. Prahlad recommended to his father that accepting vanaprastha life would be better than going deeper and deeper into Gruham Andhakupam, the blind well of life as a grihastha. In our Krishna consciousness movement, we therefore invite all the elderly persons of the world to come to Vrindavan and stay there in retired life, making advancement in spiritual consciousness, Krishna consciousness. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Supadantikam Vandeyam Shri Guru Shri Yutapada Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsa Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sayana Raghunatha Nitantam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sayana Lalita Shri Visakhanitam He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विशवानसते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदानाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नमने गौरतिसे नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे तत्साधु मन्ने असुरवर्य देहिनां सदा समुद्विग्न धिया सद्ग्रहात् हितात्म पातं गृह अंधकूपं वनं गतो यत् हरिं आश्रयेत। सो हियर इन दिस वर्स प्रहलाद महाराज इज स्पीकिंग अबाउट द जिस्ट और एसेंस of what he has learned from his spiritual master. Hiranyakashipu, the king of the demons, was very, very materialistic and against Vedic principles. He was against the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He was thinking the Supreme Personality of Godhead as his enemy. So he was expecting that his son also would follow his footsteps, become inimical towards the Supreme Personality of Godhead and become a great materialist like himself, and become a real descendant of Hiranyakashipu. That's why when Hiranyakashipu sent his son Prahlad to Gurukul, the school of Sanda and Amarka, the two sons of Shukracharya, then Hiranyakashipu was expecting that his son must have learned something nice, because every parent, they expect when their children for the first time go to the school, so the parents are enthusiastic to know how their child is progressing, how he is at school. So Hiranyakashipu one day took Prahlad Maharaj in his lap and he was asking this question. Hiranyakashipu was thinking that Prahlad is a small boy, only 5 years old boy. So he will answer very lightly of his question. So Hiranyakasipu had asked Prahlad Maharaj, my dear boy, what have you learnt yet in your school? What is the essence of that? So Prahlad Maharaj, hearing this question, he actually answered rightly the true essence of all knowledge. Though Hiranyakasipu took it otherwise, because he was expecting a materialistic answer from Prahlad Maharaj, and he would have been happy by hearing that. But Prahlad Maharaj, when he gave the true answer, what he had learned from his spiritual master, Hiranyakasipu was not very happy. He told the teachers that certainly this boy's intelligence has been spoiled by someone, the spies of Lord Vishnu. The devotees are the spies of Lord Vishnu. The devotees are preaching Krishna consciousness, sometimes openly and sometimes in disguise. So Hiranyakasipu anticipated that there must be someone who might have come to Sandamar school and had taught Prahlad this thing. Otherwise, how a 5-year-old boy could know this thing? So Hiranyakasipu was actually surprised to hear this. He was not expecting. But Prahlad Maharaj, who was a great devotee of the Lord, from his very childhood, he did not want to learn something from this sons of Shukracharya, those who are also materialistic. They were teaching Prahlad Maharaj about politics, economics, about how to rule the kingdom, how to control the enemy, all these things they were teaching him, because they were expecting him that after Hiranyakasipu, he would be the emperor, king. So he should learn all these things. And Prahlad Maharaj was never interested in all these things. Because he had already known what is the essence of life. And who was his spiritual master? Narada Muni. Narada Muni was the spiritual master. And Prahlad, when he was in the womb of his mother, he had got this instruction from Narada Muni. He was not even born. Actually, Narada Muni was giving instruction to Prahlad Maharaj's mother when he was kidnapped by the demigods. Narad Muni rescued his mother, kept in his ashram, and he was giving spiritual instruction to his mother. And Prahlad Maharaj was in the womb at that time. So when Narad Muni was instructing to his mother, Prahlad Maharaj was also listening in the womb. And he remembered all those instructions. Whereas Prahlad Maharaj's mother Kadru forgot. She could not remember all those things. So Prahlad Maharaj, from the very beginning, he has got these instructions from his spiritual master, and he is a pure devotee from his birth. So how is it that Prahlad Maharaj just got instruction from Narad Muni and immediately became a pure devotee of the Lord? Sometimes this question arises. Because after birth, Prahlad Maharaj showed the symptoms of a Mahabhagavat. Sometimes he was dancing, sometimes he was crying, sometimes He was silent when he was chanting the holy name of the Lord. All these sattvic vikar, all these symptoms were manifesting within his body. And Narad Muni, while rescuing Prahlad Maharaj's mother, he had told the demigods that, "My dear demigods, you are all planning to kill the child of Kadru, but you would not be able to kill him. He is a Mahabhagavat, great devotee of the Lord." That time Narad Muni had even not given any instruction to Prahlad Maharaj's mother. Then how did Narad Muni know that Prahlad Maharaj was a great Mahabhagavat? So Narad Muni knew that Prahlad Maharaj was not any ordinary living entity. Actually, he came from the spiritual world, Vaikuntha world. Like Jaya Vijaya, they came from the spiritual world. They were cursed by the Kumaras. So they appeared in this material world as demons. Otherwise, they were actually the inhabitants of Vaikuntha, the Lord Vishnu's eternal devotees, doorkeepers. So in the same way, Prahlad Maharaj was also a doorkeeper in Vaikuntha. His name was Sumukha. And he had once stopped the demigods to enter into Vaikuntha. But he did it respectfully. Jaya Vijaya did not respectfully stop the Kumaras. They were disrespectful. That's why they committed offense at their lotus feet. But Prahlad Maharaj, when he was doorkeeper in Vaikuntha, so he very humbly prayed to the demigods to wait a little while until he gets permission from Lord Vishnu. He was very respectful towards the demigods. And he made them wait at the door, went to ask Lord Vishnu to get his permission. Then he came and allowed them. But Lord Vishnu did not take it very lightly. Though demigods did not curse Sumukha, but Lord Vishnu said that, "You stopped my devotees at the door. That's why I want you to go to the material world, but not as a demon. You will appear as my devotee." So the same doorkeeper Sumukha came down to this material world under the order of Lord Vishnu. So he was a born Mahabhagavat. Sometimes people ask this question, or sometimes they say Prahlad Maharaj was something else in his previous life. He was attached to the prostitutes and different things. But this is the fact which has been described in Nrisimha Purana. So the same Prahlad is now giving the gist of his teachings, that how the living entity is entangled in the household life, thinking it as real, the place of real enjoyment. So that's why Prahlad Maharaj told Hiranyakasipu, "Tatsad manne asura varya dehinam sada samudvigna dhiya asadgrahat." So Prahlad Maharaj is addressing his father as Asura Varya, the king of the demons. So Hiranyakasipu was feeling proud to be addressed like that, the king of the demons. The demons, they feel proud to be addressed as demons. But nowadays demons, they don't take it nicely when they are told they are demons. Actually, their behavior is demon nowadays. People, they behave like a demon because they are against Lord Vishnu. But when someone will tell them as demon, they will not take it nicely. They will be offended. But though that time demons, they are really demons and they are feeling proud of that. They are feeling proud of declaring war against demigods and Lord Vishnu. They are true demons. So anyway, Prahlad Maharaj would have addressed his father as, "Oh my father," but he is addressing him as the king of the demons. Because Prahlad Maharaj has understood his father as a materialist, great materialistic person, against Lord Vishnu. So he is addressing as king of the demons. Asura Varya Dehinang Sada Samudvigna Dhiya. So he is not telling the gist of the teachings he has learned from his spiritual master. That Dehinang, those who have a material body, Deha, Deha means material body. So who has a material body is called Dehi. So who has a material body? The spirit soul has accepted a material body. The spirit soul is the owner of the material body. That's why it's addressed as Dehi. Dehi nosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yavanam jara. Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. So here also Prahlad Maharaj says, Dehinam sada samudvigna dhiya asad grahat. So the living entities, those who have accepted material bodies, are always samudvigna dhiya, always in great anxiety. They are always in great anxiety. Why they are in great anxiety? Prahlad Maharaj again explaining that sada samudvigna dhiya asat grahat. Because they have accepted asat, or which is temporary, as real. That's why they are in great anxiety. So the living entities, they have accepted a material body, and this material body is temporary. It will not stay with the living entity eternally. But the living entity, being influenced by the three modes of material nature, is thinking that he is this material body, instead of thinking that he is the spirit soul. The living entity is thinking that he is this material body. And because of this misconception, this living entity, he is thinking thus, "I am this material body, and anything related to my body is mine. Jivasya mohayam aham mameti." So this is illusion of the living entity. The living entity is in illusion. He is thinking that I am this material body, and anything related to this material body is mine. And this is the root cause of his anxiety. This is the root cause of his suffering, that he has accepted which is temporary as real. So the living entity is thinking he is this material body, so he is trying to take care of this material body and trying to satisfy this material body. And at the same time, he is also trying to satisfy who are related to this material body. So how one can satisfy his own material body and the material bodies of his relatives, those who are related to him? Because in material world, there are four things which the living entity want to enjoy. That is, eating, sleeping, mating and defending. Because this material body needs these four things. This is the need of the material body. The material body needs to eat because it feels hungry. The material body needs rest, that's how you go to sleep. This material body needs some sense enjoyment, sex life, that's how we accept a wife or a husband and enter into grihastha life, householder life. And then we try to protect this material body and those who are related to this material body. We give protection. So we do these four things. And we think that if we can arrange these four things for us, for me and mine, those who are related to me, then my life is successful. I am a successful householder. My life's goal is achieved. Because we have no idea except these four things. We don't know who are we, where have we come from, and why are we suffering in this material body, and how can we get out of this material body. We have no idea about these things. So out of illusion, we have forgotten that we are the spirit soul, and we are trying to satisfy this material body not only in one lifetime but life after life. When we take different bodies, in this lifetime we are in human body, in next lifetime we may be in animal body, in another lifetime we may be in bird's body. So 84 lakh species of life. That means 84 lakh different kinds of bodies we are entering one after another. And in every lifetime, in every material body, we are suffering birth, old age, disease and death. We are trying to enjoy in those material bodies these four things, and at the same time we are also suffering from birth, old age, disease and death. Still, we have not become happy. In every lifetime, we are enjoying these four things: eating, sleeping, mating and defending. Still, we are not satisfied. So, in this human form of life, which is very precious, yadapi adhruvam arthadam, though this human form is temporary, but it is very meaningful. In this human form of life, if one wants, he can get out of this life cycle. He can get out of this material body eternally, can enter into an eternal life of spiritual bliss. He will be eternally free from all anxieties, enter into Vaikuntha, which is free from all anxieties. So this human form of life is very precious in that respect. So attaining this human form of life, if someone is wasting his time in this householder life, which is called Andhakupa, a blind well. Blind well means there is a well, but there is no water in that well. And since there is no water, no one uses that well, and that's why all this grass, they come up and cover the surface of the well. Because no one uses that well, so it is covered by grass. The surface of the well is covered by grass, and sometimes people even forget that there was a well there, because no one uses that and it is not also visible. And if someone goes on that side and he does not know that there is a well, and sometimes he falls into that blind well. So when someone falls in the blind well, which is covered by grass on the top, and he is inside the well, which is completely dark, and there is no water, and full of mosquitoes and other living entities, snakes, mosquitoes and other things. So that person will be suffering in that blind well. And even if he will cry and call out for rescue, no one will listen to his crying. His cry will not actually reach to the ears of other people, because no one will be around. And he would be suffering in that blind well and would not be able to get out of that, and no one would come to rescue him. So in the same way, the householder who is thinking himself as this material body and thinking his relatives as his mind, he is suffering in this householder life. And he is suffering so much that he cannot tell others about his suffering. Because sometimes he thinks, oh, if I will tell about my suffering to my friends or to other people, what they will think of me? So I will be offended, I will be insulted. So he, though he suffers, he does not tell anyone else. And when he meets his friend, and his friend asks, oh, my dear friend, how are you? Then he smiles and he says, oh, I am fine. Though he is suffering in his householder life, throughout his householder life he is suffering, but to outside people he is smiling and telling, I am fine. He cannot even tell about his suffering to others. This is the state of affairs when someone falls in the blind well of householder life. So Prahlad Maharaj Darsha says that this falling in the house dark well of householder life is actually committing suicide, atmapatam. Like sometimes we see in material world, people, when they suffer too much and they are unable to tolerate, then they think, oh, this suffering is so much now, I am unable to tolerate any further. So what he does, he thinks, if I commit suicide, my suffering would be over. Then people commit suicide, but they don't know that instead of their suffering being over, their suffering would increase after committing suicide. He would become a ghost. He would have all the desires, but no body to fulfill. He would be wandering in a ghost body, subtle body. So, those who commit suicide, they commit suicide to get relief of suffering, but after committing suicide, they suffer more. So in the same way, Prahlad Maharaj is telling that those who are in the dark well of householder life, actually, they are committing suicide. How they are committing suicide? Because they have got this human form of life, which is a better life where one can understand that he is not this material body. He is a spirit soul, part and parcel of Krishna. And when one understands that he is part and parcel of Krishna, then he will decide what is his duty. When we will know our identity, then we will confirm about our duty. When we misidentify ourselves, then our duty is also misidentified. So if I think I am a teacher, then my duty is to teach. If I think I am a father, my duty is to take care of children. So first thing is to know who are we. So when we understand that I am the spirit soul, part and parcel of Krishna, then what is my duty as part and parcel of Krishna? Jivar Swarupa Hai, Krishna Nitya Das. My real identity is that I am servant of Krishna, because I am part and parcel of Krishna. And the servant's duty is to serve the master. So because we have misidentified ourselves, we are thinking I am such and such, that's why our duty has been changed. But when we understand our real identity, that I am servant of Krishna, I am a spirit soul, I am a servant of Krishna, and my real duty is to serve Krishna and get out of this cycle of birth and death, get out of this dark well of material existence, dark well of householder life. Because people have no knowledge of this, they think just to take care of this material body, take care of the family, is their goal of life. But when one will understand that he is a spirit soul, part and parcel of Krishna, then his duty is to serve Krishna. So one should get out of this householder life, Prahlad Maharaj says, that one should not remain in household life until death. One should get out of this householder life and prepare for death. Prepare to attain the goal of life. And how one can do? Hitatma patam groha andakupam banam gato yad harim asrayet. That one should give up this atmapata, this groha andakupam, this dark well of householder life where one is committing suicide. One should retire from householder life and go to the forest, become a vanaprastha, Vanaprastha means who lives in the vana, forest. Who goes to the forest. For what? To cultivate spiritual knowledge. To revive one's Krishna consciousness. To offer oneself completely for the service of Krishna. So in Vanaprastha life one practices this. That's why Prahlad Maharaj says, Hitatma patam gruha andhakupam banangat yad haring astrayat. So once you go to the forest, so many people also go to the forest, but they have different purpose in life. Some people go to the forest to collect some forest things, fruits, flowers, wood and other things. Some people go to the forest to perform some austerity. Some people go to the forest to get away from this materialistic way of life. So there may be different purposes. But the main purpose of going to the forest is to cultivate Krishna consciousness. Yada haring asrayata. The real purpose of going to the forest should be that one should take full shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Hari. That should be the main purpose of going to the forest. So Srila Prabhupada, in the purport, he says that going to the forest means going to Vrindavan. Because Vrindavan, where Krishna Bhakti is always prevalent. This is the place of Krishna. Vrindavan is the place of Krishna, where Krishna resides eternally. And here, those who come and take shelter of Krishna, they attain perfection in life very quickly. Like Dhruva Maharaj, being instructed by Narada Muni, so he came to Vrindavan forest, Madhuvan forest. He performed austerity, worshipped Lord Krishna, and within 6 months, he got darshan of Krishna and got benediction. He attained perfection in life. So Vrindavan is the best place to take shelter of and cultivate Krishna consciousness in which one can make his life successful. So here Prahlad Maharaj is telling this thing to his father Hiranyakashipu, that my dear king of the demons, one should give up this householder life which is just like a dark well and take shelter of Vrindavan, take shelter of Lord Hari. So Prahlad Maharaj was actually giving the gist of all knowledge to his father. And he was instructing his father to retire from this materialistic way of life and cultivate Krishna consciousness, take shelter of Lord Hari, by which his life will be successful. But Hiranyakashipu, as the king of the demons, he took it otherwise. He thought this boy's intelligence has been spoiled by the messengers of Lord Vishnu, by the devotees of Lord Vishnu. They have spoiled this boy's intelligence. Hiranyakashipu forgot that his own intelligence has been spoiled. So he thought this boy's intelligence has been spoiled. So that's why he took it otherwise and cautioned his teachers not to allow anyone to the school to spoil the intelligence of this boy and take care of her. But later on we see that actually no one had spoiled Prahlad Maharaj's intelligence. It was natural. This knowledge was natural for him because he was a pure devotee, Mahabhagavat, from the very beginning. He was a Parsad from the Vaikuntha. So no one can spoil his intelligence. He was telling the correct thing. So this is Prahlad Maharaj is telling the essence of the teachings he has received. Hare Krishna. Is there any questions or comments? Yeah. Can I give mic? Yes, actually this instruction is given to whom? Whom this instruction is given? Those who are rotting in householder life. Those who have no understanding about the goal of life. Those who have not taken shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna. This instruction is for them. Okay? And for devotees, those who have already taken shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, they may not live in Vrindavan, but they carry Vrindavan within their heart, wherever they go and wherever they preach. They preach about Krishna, they preach about Krishna's pastimes. So even they are in America, but they are in Vrindavan, if they are speaking about Vrindavan. Even Prabhupada, when he was in America, he was telling, though I am in New York, I am always thinking of Vrindavan. So I am in Vrindavan. My body is in New York. So it is the consciousness. Where our consciousness is, the consciousness is in Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness. Sometimes people may stay in Vrindavan and their consciousness may be in America. So they are not in Krishna consciousness. They are not staying in Vrindavan. Only body is staying.